Good afternoon, students. Today I will give you the remedy of yesterday's test first. Kindly go through your solutions and try to evaluate yourself just up to the mark, please. First question was, a die is thrown once. What is the probability of getting a 10? So the weightage of this question was 2 marks, so you need to write the steps somewhere. So for this question number 1, your sample space. Sample space you need to write. Once you are going to throw the dice, your sample space will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 inside the curly brackets. So these are the total possible outcomes. So probability, total possible outcomes divided by, sorry, this is total favorable outcomes divided by total possible outcomes. Please write down the steps very clearly in your answers, because question is of 2 marks. So now your favorable is 10, and 10 is not the part of your sample space, so that is 0. And divided by total possible, how many are there? 6 are there, so this is equal to 0. So answer will be 0. So half marks for this, and 1 mark to write the answer finally. So then you can write, half means you can start from here. 1 mark is from sample space, so that way answer is coming is equal to 0. Sample space is very important in probability. Please write the total possible outcomes. 1 mark to write the sample space, then the formula, that is empirical probability, is always equal to favorable divided by total possible. Here favorable is not lying in your sample space, so that is equal to 0. Impossible event, and hence the answer will be equal to 0. Question number 2. This was of 3 marks. A coin is tossed 100 times. How many times will a head come up? Again, you need to write the sample space. You know, when you are going to toss a coin, probability is either head or tail. Now what happens? Coin is tossed. So again, you need to write this step, and then how many times will a head comes up? So favorable is head. Head is 1, that is equal to 1. Total is 2. So I'm just writing, head is your favorable. Head is coming only once out of 2. So total possible is 2. So probability of coming head in one toss, this is in one toss, will be equal to 1 by 2. Already I have explained it to you. So, but the coin was tossed how many times? 100 times. So when coin is tossed 100 times, so therefore probability of coming head will be equal to, how many times the heads will come up? 50 times. So your answer will be 50 times the head will come up. If the coin is tossed, how many times? 100 times. So first of all, in such questions, you need to find the probability in one toss. So in one toss, the probability of getting head is always 1 by 2. Even tail is always 1 by 2. So but the coin was tossed 100 times. So 100 times, so how many times the tail will come up? Answer will be 50 times. Question was of 3 marks. Again, 1 mark for this, 1 mark for this, and 1 mark for this. In that way, step marking you can follow. To evaluate yourselves, you'll be getting 3 marks if the answer is correct up to the mark. Then third question was repeatedly, I have given you second time in a test to draw the histogram, because I am putting stress upon this question, as histogram is the part of your class 9 somewhere. So data was given of 30 workers in a factory where their distribution, weekly wages were given, and you were supposed to start your class interval somewhere from 900. So you know your class intervals and then frequency are the tables required in your frequency table. Conditionally, it was given that you have to start onwards 900. So please apply your presence of mind and follow the instructions. There are four readings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 readings are there, which are in terms of 800. That is 860, 832, 833, 855, 845, 804. So no need to consider these readings, as the condition in the question is you have to start onwards 900. So follow the instruction. So this is the presence of mind you need to apply. Total readings are 34. So how many you have rejected now? 6 are less than that of 900. So please don't consider those in your this tabular form. So now sum of your frequencies is very clear. Out of 36 you have left, so that must be equal to 24. So from where you can start is, you have to start onwards 900 to 910, then 910 to 920, 920 to 930, 930 to 940, 940 to 950, 950 to 960, 960 to 970, 970 to 980, 980 to 990, and finally it is 990 to 1000. So these are the class intervals which are required as per your question. And now find the frequencies. If you go for this, the frequency for this you are getting one. Only one reading is there, that is 906, lying between 900 and 910. I repeat, this is the exclusive data which we need to draw the histogram. So no need to consider 910 here. That's why this is called exclusive. 910 will be the part of your next class interval. So only one reading you are finding, that is your 906. So frequency will be one. Then in this 910 to 920, there are three readings falling. 910 is two times, and then 912 is also there. So frequency for this will be three. Then 920 to 930, again only one reading is there, that is 920. Then 930 to 940, if you go, so 930, 935, 935, 936, again 935, again 935, 936, and then it is 930. I repeat, 930, 935, 935, 936, 935, 935, 936, and 930. Two times 930, two times your 936, and four times your 935. So in that way, the frequency comes is 8. If you check this 940 to 950, there are three readings only. 940, 940, 940. Three times is coming, so frequency will be 3. In 950 to 960, nothing is there, so it becomes 0. And then 960 to 970, only one reading, that is 968, so frequency will be 1. 970 to 980, there are three readings again, 970, 975, 978, so frequency will be 3. Then 980 to 990, only one reading is there, that is 985, so frequency will be 1 only. And finally, for 990 to 1000, there are three values, and 990 is repeated three times, so frequency will be 3. Now you add these 3 and 1, 4, or 1, 5, or 8, 13, or 3, 16, 17, 20, 21, 24. So I told, if you start onwards 900, so only 24 will be left, because 6 are less than that of 900, that need not to be considered as per the instruction given in the question. And histogram, you know all data, you need to give a kink over here. 10 your columns will be there, and frequency is coming here 1, 3, 8, 3, 1. So you just can start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, like this somewhere, and give a kink and start onwards 900 to 910. And keep on drawing the bars. It is up to 1. So please, it is up to 1. Next is again up to 3. Extend that and draw it up to 3, 920. And so on in continuity up to 1000. You can draw the histogram. So that is the solution. So you just see if you have started onwards 900. So you keep reserved 2 marks for your table if all the frequencies are correct. In between somewhere 950 to 960, 920, 930, 940, 950 to 960 when you are coming. So no need to show anything because frequency is 0, so no rectangle will be there. So then you start with 960 to 970. So there will be a break. One part will be before 950 and then another will start onwards 960 because between 950 to 960 the frequency is 0. And 2 marks for your correct histogram. So please keep a check upon this. Then your next question was, a group of people were asked about their favorable car colors. The result is shown by the following pie chart. Pie chart was given to you. So that was something like this. If you have studied, done, this angle was of 90 degree, then this was of 5x and this was of 4x. This symbol denotes 90. So here this was a silver color, this was the white color, and this was the blue color. You were supposed to calculate x, no problem should be there in first part. You know 4x plus 5x plus 90 is equal to 360. So 9x is equal to 360 minus 90. 9x is equal to 270. So x is equal to 30 degree should be the answer for the particular value of your x. Then you need to find if 90 people like silver color. So silver color is here. Number of people means angle at the center. Second part I am giving to you. Angle at the center is 90. Value of the single item, that is also given, 90 people. The number of people who like silver is 90. Out of what? Out of total, you need to determine into 360. I don't know the total number of people that I want to determine because that is the second part. If 90 people like silver, find the total number of people. So let the total number of people, that is x. So cross multiply 90 into x is equal to 90 into 360. So 90 you can cancel with 90. So your answer x will be equal to 360. So total number of people in that group will be equal to 360 will be the answer for this. So 2 parts, 2 marks. This was of 3. So 1.5 for this and 1.5 for this. So in that way you can evaluate yourself in by doing the step marking for 3 marks. Then it was the last part somewhere, question number 5 was there, in which you have to draw the pie chart as per the given information. So total it was category and amount was given. For food it was 10,000, clothes it was 50,000. So items were food, then it was clothes, then it was education, then savings and others. So as I told ki, to draw the pie chart or to read the pie chart, you need to draw the angles. Angle for food will be of, that will be equal to, as you just can do the total of all these items, that is coming somewhere is 50,000 is the total amount, plus like for food it is 10,000 into 360. Please do these calculations very carefully. And 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros straight away you can cancel here, and then check this angle 72. So in that way you can just calculate all these values. 72 degree for this, for this it will be 36, for this it will be 108, then for this it will be 90 degree, and finally this is equal to 54 degree. So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, as I have explained you to how to get the value of angle, value of the single item that is given to you per category. Like for clothes, you will be writing 5000 upon 50000 into 360. Then it is 15000 upon 50000 into 360. Then it is 12500 upon 50000 into 360, and finally 7500 upon 50000 into 360. We will give you these 5 angles. Then you draw the 5 angles and draw the pie chart. So 2 marks for this calculation. So 2 means angles you please check, and 2 marks to draw the pie chart. In that way, the question will be of 4 marks. This is of 3 marks. Then you please divide 1.5 for this and 1.5 for pie chart. So 3 marks you can give to yourself if it is up to the mark. So that's all about your remedy of the test. Please evaluate yourselves and see the score. And if any mistakes are there, please do the correction. And if I speak from your exercise point of view, so yesterday I have shared first question of your exercise 9.2. Keep on doing that. Suppose I am taking the 6th part, binomial with binomial L6, then it is minus m raised to the power 6 into L square plus m square. One or two part I will be taking. If this is L6, then this is L square plus m square minus m raised to the power 6 L square plus m square. So I said you have to multiply both first with this and then with this. Rest of the procedure is same, plus into plus, plus 6 plus 2 L raised to power 8, again plus L6 m square minus into plus minus m6 L square minus into plus minus and m raised to the power 8. All unlike terms are there, so please leave your answer here only. Similarly, suppose I am taking the 8th part. This was your 6th part, and now if I pick the 8th part somewhere, you see that is a plus 2 upon 7 b square into 7a minus b square into 7a minus b square. Take your time to understand. So first a with 7a minus b square, then it is a turn of 2 upon 7 b square with 7a minus b square, and keep on multiplying plus 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 7a into a 7a square plus minus minus a into b square is a b square. Then here it is, you multiply the numerics, plus into plus is plus 2 upon 7 into 2, do it within the brackets, into 7, it is 2 upon 7 into 7. Numerics I have taken together, and b square into a, again it will make somewhere a b square. And finally then it is plus minus is minus, here it is 1, so 2 upon 7 b square into b square will make it b raised to the power 4. Here you can cancel this 7 with this 7, we are getting 7a square minus ab square plus 2ab square minus ab square plus 2ab square minus 2 upon 7 b raised to the power 4. As you can see, these are the like terms, can be added or subtracted. 1 is plus, 1 is minus, so I need to subtract. Do that, 7a square plus minus minus, minus plus term is greater, so sign will be of plus. 1ab square means ab square only, and minus 2 upon 7 b raised to the power 4. Here you can leave your answer. So that is 2 parts I picked up from these 8 parts. Rest of the parts you try. If any difficulty is there, please let me know by sending the comments. I'll do that for you. Otherwise, you keep on trying all these parts and take your time. Again and again, I am requesting you people. And then second question. Again, binomial with binomial, but 2 times. Important question from the examination point of view also. So suppose I am taking the second part here. What you have to do, 3b plus 2 into 5b minus 4, then it is minus b minus 5 into 3b plus 2, means somewhere I have to do it twice, binomial with binomial. So you use the square bracket there, put the sign of equal to, and start doing 3b with 5b minus 4. Then it is a turn of 2 with 5b minus 4, and close this bracket. Similarly here, put this b with 3b plus 2, and then minus 5 with 3b plus 2, like this. And then 3b into 5b plus into plus plus. Then you can start with the small bracket only. This will be 15b square plus minus minus 3 4s are 12b plus 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 2 5s are 10b plus minus minus 8, and close the bracket. Minus again here, b into 3, 3b square, b into 2, 2b, minus into 5, 3, minus 15b, and minus plus minus 5, 2s are 10, close the bracket. Now you can solve these like terms first. 15b square minus 2b minus 8. Now you know all how I am getting these terms. And then it is 3b square plus minus. This will be of minus because minus is greater. And this will be 13b minus 10. Finally you solve the bracket now. 15b square minus 2b minus 8. Open the bracket. Negative sign is there. Minus 3b square plus 13b and plus 10. Change all the signs here. Again, you are getting the like terms. Better, you can do it directly also. This is 2b. Then you see these are again the like terms. 15b square minus 13b square will make it 12b square. Minus 2b plus 13b will make it plus 11b. And minus 8 plus 10 will make it 2. So finally you can check your answer. 12b square plus 11b plus 2. So that is the solution. This is the question of section C. 3 marks. And very important from the understanding point of view. Again, I am saying you take your time. Don't be in a hurry. Nothing different we are doing here. Binomial with binomial. Again, binomial with binomial. But another operation is added between somewhere, that is of subtraction. Product of these two. You need to subtract with product of these two, and then all things together you can check finally how we have to proceed. So please don't be in hurry. I am requesting you people again and again, keep patience, keep on repeating if you are not getting the correct answer at once, and then the other parts are there, you can try. And if you are not getting somewhere, at last you see binomial with trinomial is also there. And in question number 3 also, again you need to find the product of binomial with binomial. So you can do that. Suppose I am taking the second part of your question number 3. And then finally you have to substitute the value of x and y, whatever are given to you. Like this is 3x minus 2y into, then it is 2x plus 5y. And you have to calculate finally for x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. So again the procedure is same, 3x into 2x plus 5y, don't worry about anything, and then minus 2y, 2x plus 5y. So 3 plus, plus into plus plus, 3 2s are 6, then it is x square, plus plus plus, 3 5s are 15, x into y will make it xy. Minus plus minus, 2 2s are 4, again x into y will make it xy. Minus plus minus, and 2 5s are 10, that is y square. So this is 6x square, 15, and here it is 4xy square, 4xy. So 15 minus 4 is 11, as these are the like terms. So 11xy minus 10y square. Now you can put x is equal to 0, so this will make 0, 11, again 0. See the beauty of this question finally, and then it is 1 square. So without any hesitation, 0, 0 multiplied by anywhere will make it 0 minus 10, because minus into plus is, so your answer will be equal to what? Minus 10. I've seen the students many times what they are doing. Without finding the product directly, they are substituting the values here. And then what happens? You see, this will become 0, this will become minus 2, and again this will become 0, and this will become plus 5. Minus 2 into plus 5 again will make it minus 10. So in that way, if you are doing, that answer will not be entertained. First, you have to find a product like this, and once you have reached here, then you have to substitute the values. So that practice you need to do. Please keep a watch upon your solution and steps of your answer. Do not substitute the values like this directly here in place of x, y without finding the product. First, you have to find the product, then you have to substitute the values. So I hope you will try your level best to get the solution of all these parts. That ends your exercise 9.2. Some special products we will start tomorrow. Thank you.